Dobrý den. How to pronounce the Czech R? How to R? Why do you ask? Please don't fuss about R. R is just a sound. It's not a very beautiful sound. It's not a very elegant sound. So don't worry too much about it. There are tips how to pronounce it as a native Czech speaker. And there are tips how to pronounce it as a stranger, brave Czech student who is learning Czech. So really not a big deal. And Czech is not the only language having R. So don't worry about it, really. Trust me, R, 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 R. Doesn't matter. Which matters is the message you have and already to speak Czech when you are not a native speaker. It's a miracle. Let's make a deal. Try it 1,000 times and if you don't succeed, forgot about it. Let's go. 3 short methods. A preliminary condition to pronouncing R is to know how to pronounce the European continental R or Mexican, Spanish R. How to R? The tip of your tongue will touch the front ridges on your upper palate, the little undulations or hills, exactly on the same spot that you touch when you say L. But when I say L, I don't release any air, because if I do, it will make R. R. You see? A tip from a stranger, his advice is to slightly tilt your head up. Look at the ceiling. R. Well, yes. Maybe it's easier. And now, when you know how to say R, you can proceed with R. Why? Because the method will be quite similar to some point. First method, 4 steps. Start from the same position as for R, but the tongue is going slightly forward. Second step, you lessen the angle of the jaws. Third step, you sharpen the coins of your mouth, which means that you will slightly pout your lips. And fourth, you release air with more velocity. We have, in fact, 2 kind of R's. So the first one is in the beginning or in the middle of the word, where it is very strong. For example, rzasa, řek, pořád, řeka. The second R will be lighter, nearly a whisper, pepř or motř. Řek, r. Motř, r. R, r. See, there is a difference. So we are done with the first method. Wow, good job. Now the second method. We join the jaws, put the teeth together, pout the lips moderately, and pronounce R. Let's try. Yes, there is some kind of R. Pouting the lips with one hand and whispering the R may help. So let's try. Rrrrsh. Okay, yes, it becomes something like rrrsh. You can't say rrrsh. It's difficult. We are done with the second method. And third method brings us naturally to what we were saying already, which is pout the lips, join your teeth, and do not say, but actually whisper the r. So let's try the third method. Pout the lips, join your teeth, and do not say, but whisper r. Well, I believe it's nearly the same what we have done. So, as we can see, the first method was very rich, very complicated. And as we proceed forward, the methods tend to have less and less steps. The first method I gathered from a site of Czech. I can't pronounce this. Orthophonist. It's very difficult. To conclude this heavy subject, I have some tips for you from other foreigners. So, a lot of strangers say we can also join the letters R and SH, RSH, or R and ZH. Rž. Yes, if we really cannot or are disgusted with learning Rž, we can do this. It will never sound like Rž, but well, it's a choice. It's a possible choice, and don't worry, you will be understood. Second tip, very nice. Some consonants are more friendly to the Rž than others. So, for example, the consonant B is very friendly in dobře. Dobře. Maybe you will find this easier. This kind of advice I really cannot give you because I'm not confronted to this difficulty. My difficulty is orthophonist. This is problem for me. And now, dear students, I'm giving you Neklan. Who has a message for you? Brzy na shledanou. Jo tak, ty neumíš říct ř. Hele, vole. Co jsem vole? Dej. Zuby k sobě, jo, takhle. A potichu. Šeptem. Řekni r. A ne takhle, ne. Musíš dát čelistí k sobě. R. No, to je ono. Re. Re. Jo? Karate kid. R.
Ř.
R.
Ř.
No. Znáš? No, to je ono. R. Ona neví. Ženská. Muž!